Welcome to Crafting with Louisa. Louisa here, and today I'm going to do a sparkly poinsettia Christmas card. I'm going to use watercolours for this, but any colour medium that you feel comfortable with. I've used a couple of new things actually, a new stamp set. For the Love of Stamps, excuse me, by Hunkadori, and it's the poinsettia one, pretty poinsettia. I'm going to use that large one, and I'm going to use that leaf because I'm going to do a bit of masking. So here I've just stamped the large poinsettia just on a piece of printer paper, and I've just stuck a bit of my Snell adhesive on the back and taking quite a lot of the sticky off on my jeans so that it's not going to rip the paper. So I've got that, and I'm also going to use, I don't know how well the camera will pick up that sparkle on there, and I've used the Spectrum Noir Sparkle Pen Crystal Clear. I've done it on the back of that first mat, but if you've got glimmer paper or glitter paper, you just as well to use that, but I didn't have any and I wanted just to bring in the little sparkle that I've got there onto the outside, so that's why I've done that. So I'll stick that there. So you'll need a card base, which is 4 1/8 by 5 3/4, and I think that is half an A4 piece of cardstock cut in half, but adjust this to whatever card bases you use. And then I've got a piece of watercolour card, because as I said, I'm going to use my Cotman watercolours. So you need one of those, and then you need the first card base, which is going to be this red, which is 3 7/8 by 5 1/2, but all these will be on the blog, on the website. And then the second mat, which I've just got some Distress watercolour cardstock, which is 3 5/8 by 4 1/4. So I think what I'm going to do first, so that it can dry a bit, is I'm just going to run my sparkle pen across. You've got Winkostella, use that. Much better. Okay. Then what you need to do is get that and find out where it lines up. Now, if you've got masking paper, use that by all means. Oh, bit of extra paper. So basically, I don't know whether these actually are a poinsettia leaf, because they don't look like the others, but they look enough like it that I don't mind. So and the colours I'm using, I've got a couple of different reds, and they're a cad red and a cad red dark. And then in this set, it's only got one green in it, which is sap green. So I've got a sap green on its own, and then a sap green with a tiny touch of ultramarine. So I'm just going to go around and decide where I want an extra leaf. And this is quite a big stamp, so I quite like that. So edge it in, you know, don't have them all sticking out the same distance. And I think another one there. Okay. think maybe actually a touch of one, just picking up there. Okay, so let's fold that away. And you can decide that I'm going to stick that back down, because I decided that I want something sticking out there. Now, I did a background on the other one. I don't know that I'm going to do one on this one. There. Something like that. And a tip from, who was it? Helen Griffin, I think. If you, when you've got stamps that come in a packet like that, just cut a tiny slither off one side and then they're easy to get in and out. Because I've been struggling for years with that stupid sticky bit. Until I watched that and I thought, ah. So I've pre-sprayed my paint and I've got clean and dirty water. So I'm going to go in with, I think it's a Cad Red Deep. And I haven't wet these before. You can do if you want to. Now, I was going to do this in my iridescent paints, and then I realised I didn't have a green, and I didn't have any colours to make a green. So that's why I've put a bit of sparkle on it. Going around and do, I'm just going to do alternate ones for now. This is lovely in alcohol markers. I just happen to quite like watercolour. Going, I think this is just Cad Red, and I'm just gonna go in and just darken that up near the base. I don't know how much that will show, in all honesty. Okay. So feel free, if you don't want it sparkly, you can admit the sparkle pen, but it's Christmas, who doesn't like a bit of sparkle at Christmas? And the sparkle pens are new, I mean they're not new, I think they've been out for a while. They're new to me, I just picked them up at Hobbycraft. They come in a set of three, actually. Now I've just gone into that berry a bit there. Not a berry, because I don't think they have, I don't think poinsettias have berries. Whatever they are, anyway. So just go on around where you think the leaves, the flowers. Okay. Oops, don't do what I just did. Guess that'll be a flower. I never know whether these are flowers or modified leaves. Somebody will tell me. And then I've got a bit more concentrated, which is not a bad thing. I'm going to leave some of these outside ones to be green. So just going to go in with a bit of water and drag a bit of that colour so we've got a bit more of a shadow. I'm not a watercolourist. So please forgive me. But yeah, there's nothing nicer than getting a handmade card. Fine going from one red to red without it drying, because if they go run off it doesn't really matter, but as soon as I get into the green I want to make sure that my red's dry, otherwise it will get mud. These red and green are opposites on the colour wheel. So, I do just want to be careful of that. So, just be mindful of that. Okay, so I'm going to dry that with my heat gun. We could just wait for this to dry naturally. Dry enough, so now I'm going to go in with the green, which is sap green in here. Actually, I've changed my mind. I'm going to make that one a leaf, and not a leaf. These red things. And if you look up poinsettias, they actually come in the most amazing colours. That aren't always the traditional red. You can get some that are to the yellowy colours, maybe even purple, so just have a look. Right, now I'm going to dry that again. So now I really am ready to go in with the green. So again, into the green. Now I like cotton colours, this sap green. In here. I find a bit insipid somehow. So I'm just going to get the I think there is a Cotman Hooker's green, which is a darker green, so I might have to go in. Because the, I never, well, no, I never use, unless it's, which is the first class item, I'm just going in with a bit more concentration, that you could use a darker green if you wanted to. My first ever watercolour class did involve a white. And that was for a technique rather than for a colour, if that makes sense. And this came with it, same with black, I never used black. And of course, watercolour sets always come with a black. So I've got, because this is the one I'm using is a full pan version rather than half. So, I don't know whether you can get full pans individually or half. So I've got some space where the black and the white paint was that I would never use. So I've got a space for that. So I'll it's a nice set, actually. So I'm just going to dry that and be back. That's dry, so I'm going to go in with straight from the pan so that I can get some of those veins a little bit done. I'm going to do is go into, I think it was a CAD yellow, any yellow really, that's what that says. And I don't even know whether those are yellow. In my world they are. Okay, so I want to dry that thoroughly. With the other card, I went full on sparkle. You can do that. What I might do on this one is, and you will need a bit of scrap of paper, because it does, because I think these are water based, so it does pick up a tiny bit of the paint, but as long as you just dab it off straight away, it doesn't affect it. And don't squeeze. If you squeeze and keep squeezing, it just, it'll flow out forever. You only need a little squeeze before you start. So I'm gonna, and you will need to give it a shake. And then here, just dab it off, and then excuse me, I think what I'm going to do is, I've got sparkle all over my, excuse my mat, it's quite messy. So I think what I might do is, Now let yeah. Now let's go full on sparkle. I'm just gonna go on the red parts. And as you can see, it does pick it up a bit on there, but it does rub off. And if you've got any of these pens, whether it's this one or the Winkostella, when they're empty, don't throw the barrels away, because you can use them as a water brush. A sparkly water brush. That sparkle will stay in there, but this does... can't always pick up the sparkle until it's dry. So there, I'm just gonna, okay, so if we can see a bit of that sparkle, it'll get more sparklier as it dries. So got our other bit here. Can you see there now? I hope that's picking up on the camera. Oh yeah, that's picking up quite well actually. Please, okay. So before I do anything and let that dry, I have got a sentiment. I think that does come with a sentiment, does it? Yeah, you could use one of those. I'm using this Tidings of Comfort and Joy, which I think is a stamping up. Not think, it is a stamping up stamp. I'm assuming they still do it, I don't know. I don't know what stamp it was. I think is it Christmas Pines or something? Okay, so that's the inside of the card done. I should make a minute for that to dry, shouldn't I? You don't specify. Okay, so now, because this has gone wavy, because you've wetted it and heated it, put lots of glue on the back. You could use double-sided. You could actually pop this up. I didn't. So that's gonna go. Is it gonna be a bit mucky? Some mucky fingers. It's pressed too hard on it because I don't know how dry that is. I don't want to squash that. That should be dry enough. I don't know about you, but I always find that pre-made card bases are never folded as accurately sometimes you can do at home. I don't know why that is. Perhaps it's just me. So that is our sparkly blingy card. Okay, that's our two versions. That's the one I've done before. I don't know whether I'll put more glitter on now, just because it's dry that it looks more glittery. But you can see the glitter on there. So those are the two cards. That would look really cute with a little bow on it, if you wanted to add that. But thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!